哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak.
主所亲爱的大家，晚上平安。
Our brothers and sisters, from the Lord Jesus' last peace be with you.
我们靠着圣灵的帮助，我们继续来讲解从使徒行传看教会危机。
By the help of the Holy Spirit, we'll continue to look at the crisis of the church from Acts of the Apostles.
我们继续看魔鬼破坏教会的手段这个主题。
We continue to look at the theme of the schemes of Satan in destroying the church.
那么，我们从第四章看到魔鬼破坏教会所用的三个手段。
From chapter 4 alone, we found out about the three schemes of Satan in destroying the church.
第一个手段是用强硬的手段对付教会。
The first being the being by force in treating the church.
第二个是用软化的手段使教会来妥协。
Secondly, was a soft tactic to cause the church to come to a compromise.
那第三个是用恐吓的手段来使教会来害怕。
And the third being threatening the church to make them afraid.
我们也做了一些魔鬼恐吓教会的见证。
We also testified about how the devil had previously threatened us.
但是我们看到在第四章。教会靠着圣灵以及他们同心合意，胜过了撒旦的攻击，胜过了撒旦的试探。
But in chapter 4, we are also able to witness that the Holy Spirit has helped the church to overcome all these schemes and tactics of the devil.
不单止教会没有被魔鬼击倒，
Not only has the devil failed to attack the church,
反而教会在撒旦的攻击当中来成长。
and the church has instead been able to grow and develop in the resistance of the devil.
教会在撒旦的破坏当中大大的得胜。
And in the attempt of Satan trying to destroy the church has become victorious.
所以，我们从第四章看到，教会有四种的大见证，有四种的大见证。
And therefore, in chapter 4, we can see the four major testimonies of the church in chapter 4.
那就是30节的第一个。
The first one in verse 30.
第一个是说，大放胆量。这里说，叫你的仆人大放胆量。
It tells us that so that the servants could be courageous.
这个特别是在福音宣道上，
That is especially in terms of preaching of the
特
gospel,
别是在勇敢的见证主耶稣。
that we are able to testify and witness about the Lord Jesus with all boldness.
这确实需要很大的胆量。
It all requires a lot of courage and boldness.
那第二个大就是大家公用，凡物大家公用。
The second testimony was about they were sharing in all things.
就是在32节，
That is recorded in verse 32.
没有一个人说他的东西有一样是他自己的。
None of them none of them wanted to own anything of their own.
这个是教会达到最荣耀的状态。
This is when the church has achieved the most glorious state.
是达到最圣洁的状态，
The most holy state.
是达到最完全的状态。
The most perfect state.
没有一个人说他的自己的东西是他自己的，都是大家的。
No one claimed whatever that he or she possessed was his own.
那等下你就会看到为什么第五章亚拿尼亚夫妻会被审判的原因，跟这个32节就直接有关系。
And later you will see the reason why Ananias and his wife were judged. It was because of this verse in verse 32.
那第三个见证就是大有能力。
And the third testimony was about them being given great power.
看到吗？33节，使徒大有能力见证主耶稣复活。
Do you see that in verse 33 that the apostles had great power to witness the resurrection of the Lord Jesus?
在敬拜上，在侍奉上，都充满着能力的。
And they were full of power in worship and service.
唱诗有力量，
They were full of power when they
祷告
sang
有力量，
They were full of power when they prayed.
讲道有力量，
They were full of power when they spoke
做
sermons.
圣工有力量。
They were full of power when they did divine work.
那第四个见证是什么呢？
What's the fourth testimony?
可以说，众人也都蒙大恩，大大的蒙恩。
It tells us that the multitudes and the people were all full of grace.
在他们的信仰生活上都蒙神极大的恩典。
And in their livelihood and in their spiritual life, they were all experiencing great grace.
魔鬼要攻击教会，要摧毁教会，教会反而活出了四大见证出来。
And now you can see that while the devil has been trying to attack the church, and the church is able to demonstrate and manifest these four major testimonies.
这都是圣灵的工作来的。
All these have been the work of the Holy Spirit.
那撒旦向教会兴起了攻击跟破坏。
And Satan has arisen, attack and also attempts to destroy the church.
但是神却借助魔鬼的破坏来使教会得造就。
But by these attempts of Satan to destroy the church, the church has been greatly edified.
教会所面临的试探却成了教会的祝福。
And the test that came upon the church has turned into the grace and blessings to the church.
那只要我们神的儿女们来同心。
As long as the children of God are united in the heart.
祷告。
In prayer.
被圣灵充满。
And to be full of the Holy Spirit.
我们便能够得胜而荣耀的。
Then we will become victorious and be receive glory.
同心
to be united in heart, in prayer,
被圣灵充满
to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
我们这样就可以得胜，也可以荣耀，得荣耀啊，就可以发出荣耀光。
Be able to become victorious and be and receive glory.
这是第四章啊，这个就是第四章我们所看见的教会得胜的见证。
This is a testimony of the church emerging victorious in chapter 4.
那现在我们进入到第五章里面去。
Now we enter into chapter 5.
当教会大大蒙恩的时候，
While the church has been full of grace and blessings,
属灵的质与量不住的不断的在提升的时候，
While the spiritual quality and standard of the church continue to increase,
那撒旦的破坏我们看到又跟着来了。
But the destruction of the devil continued to come along as well.
所以我们应该清楚地明白，撒旦他绝对不肯束手就缚的，他不肯这样来认输的。
We have to fully recognize that Satan would not be admitting defeat.
他也不会眼巴巴看到教会不断的成长，然后他什么都不能够做，然后他只能够等候进入那个地狱的永火。他不可能这样的。
And it is impossible for the devil to stand aside and cross his arms and just wait for the day of judgment to come on himself.
在第四章，他早前的恐吓，早前的三种手段都没有功效。
And in chapter 4, the devil realized that all his tactics before did not come to work for them.
如今呢，到第五章的时候，我们看到魔鬼他改变了另一种方式来对付教会。
And when we arrive at chapter 5, we can see that the tactic of the devil has changed.
如果外面的压力不行，那么他就用里面的计划、里面的计谋 来进行。
Since the schemes and tactics externally did not work against the church, then the devil has switched into internal tactics.
因此到第五章的时候，我们看到魔鬼在教会里面就找到了亚拿尼亚这对夫妻了。
And which is why you can see in chapter 5, the devil has found Ananias and his wife as his tools.
所以第五章呢，我给的题目叫做“魔鬼腐化教会”。
Which is why I have entitled the theme for chapter 5 as "The Devil Corrupting the Church."
腐化就是让教会腐烂掉嘛，在里面开始腐烂嘛。
That is where the church begins to deteriorate from inside.
这一章呢？我们会看到魔鬼从两方面来攻击教会。
From this chapter, we can see the devil has begun to attack the church from two aspects.
第一方面是从内部里面来腐化教会。
The first aspect being trying to corrupt the church and deteriorate the church from inside.
第二方面呢，是从外部呢来继续逼迫教会。
And the second direction is from the outside continue to persecute the church.
对，我们看到第五章的攻击比第四章的攻击来得更加的猛烈。
And now we can see that the attack and the destruction of the devil has become more aggressive than chapter 4.
因为魔鬼这次是内在跟 里面跟外面都来攻击的，都来破坏的。
Because now we can see that the destruction of the devil has come from within and without.
里面就是里面的弟兄姐妹，知道吗？
When we say within, it is referring to the members of the church.
好，那我们来看《使徒行传》第五章。
We look at chapter 5, Acts of the Apostles.
我读一节到六节。
Allow me to read from verse 1 to 6.
智慧你读七节到十一节。
Okay.
一二三。有一个人名叫亚拿尼亚，同他的妻子撒菲拉卖了田产，把嫁银私自留下几分，他的妻子也知道其余的几分哪来放在使徒脚前。彼得说，亚拿尼亚，为什么撒旦充满了你的心，叫你欺哄圣灵，把田地的嫁银私自留下几分呢？田地还没有卖，不是你自己的吗？竟卖了，嫁银不是你做主吗？你怎么心里起这意念呢？你不是欺哄人，是欺哄神了。第五节，亚拿尼亚听见这话，就扑倒断了气，听见的人都甚极怕。第六节，有些少年人起来，把他包裹抬出去埋葬了。请读第七节。
I'll be reading from verses 7 to 11. Verse 7. Now it was about 3 hours later when his wife came in, not knowing what had happened. And Peter answered her, Tell me whether you sold the land for so much. She said, Yes, for so much. Then Peter said to her, How is it that you have agreed together to test the Spirit of the Lord? Look, the feet of those who have buried your husband are at the door, and they will carry you out. Then immediately she fell down at his feet and breathed her last. And the young man came in and found her dead, and carrying her out, buried her by her husband. So great fear came upon the church and upon all who heard these things.
好，那么我们第五章第一节原文里面有说，然而有一个人，英文的King's James 英文也有说 but 有一个人，对不对？智慧，你的英文有这样讲吗？
有。
OK， 那为什么会这样讲呢
？Why is it that in chapter 5 verse 1 it is recorded but a certain man named？
那因为里面有看到这个奉献里面有看到真奉献跟假奉献的一个对比。
Because with regards to their offerings, there have been true offerings and also false offerings.
谁真奉献，谁假奉献？
Who have offered true offerings and who have offered false offerings?
我们看回第四章的36到37节。
We read back to chapter 4, verse 36 to 37.
来，我们一起读来36节。
Let's read 36.
有一个利未人生在基比路，名叫叶瑟。使徒称他为巴拿巴，巴拿巴翻出来就是劝慰子。他有田地也卖了，把嫁银拿来放在使徒脚前。这个第四章最后一段说，巴拿巴他也卖田地来奉献给主啊。
In chapter 4, the last two verses tell us that even Barnabas have sold his land to offer the money to the Lord.
这个巴拿巴我们在圣经里面非常熟悉啊。
Barnabas is someone that we are very familiar with.
圣经说他是一个好人，巴拿巴是一个好人啊。
The Bible recorded him as a good man.
我们没有想到他爱主的心哦，都比很多很多人都很完全啊，都很大很深啊。
We could hardly imagine his heart for the Lord Jesus had been so great and deep.
他不单只自己奉献出来做圣工。
Not only had he offered himself to serve the Lord in the ministry.
没有想到他连他自己的产业、自己的田地也卖了，完全奉献给教会。那等于说他自己没有产业了，没有身家了。
We did not expect him to have sold his own land and possessions, leaving himself nothing for his own possession.
他不单只整个人奉献给神，连他所有的产业也奉献给神。
Not only have he offered himself to the ministry, but he also offered all that he possessed, his property and possessions, to the Lord God.
我现在在想我们今天当传道的我自己了，不要讲别人了，讲我自己啊。
If I were to examine myself,
我们整个人奉献给神了，那 OK 的，那应该没问题的。
It is no problem that I offer myself to the Lord God.
但是如果主耶稣哈，如果神要我把的产业、我的田地也完全的奉献给主，五分钱也不能够留，我想这个就比较有困难了。
But it will come to prove very challenging for me to try to offer my property and all that I possess to the Lord God.
因为我们会考虑到家庭啊，要考虑到孩子啊，考虑到太太啊，我们考虑很多东西啊。
We are very concerned about a lot of things about our family, our wife, and our children.
我在想了，如果真的神这样来要求啊，我们做得到吗？我们做得到吗？
Just thinking to myself, if the Lord ever was to require us to do all this, are we able to achieve?
当然感谢神，神没有这样的要求。
We thank God that the Lord does not require us to do this.
因为等下我们会看到，神根本没有要求他们要把全田地卖了全部奉献。其实神根本没有这样的要求，知道吗？
And in fact, we can also find out that the Lord has never required them to offer all that they possessed.
有些弟兄姐妹误会，以为教会达到这种圣洁的时候，就卖田卖地全部给教会才叫做完全。其实教神没有这样要求，教会也没有这样的规定，没有这样的规定。
Some brothers and sisters have misunderstood that for the church to achieve a perfect state, we will have to sell off all our possessions and property, but this is not required by the Lord God.
可是就是大家自动的爱主，这样来奉献。
And instead, it is still by the initiative of everybody to offer all the head.
因为他们要追求达到真正的一家人，不分彼此，不分你我，没有私心，没有私自自己的东西，达到真正的一家人。
Simply because that we all wanted to aspire and to achieve that we are able to come to a perfect state of the church where we are all in one heart and in one family, owning nothing but sharing in everything.
你私自的产业，你有私自的财产，有私自的钱财，有这个私自的私人的那个私人的，就没有办法真正的老实说是一家人了，因为都很多只是你的、我的、他的，很多东西都是你不能够去用人家的东西，那叫做一家人吗？
Because while you still want to own a piece of possession for yourself, and we will never be able to achieve the one family spirit in the church.
所以他们是圣灵感动自己这样做，自愿这样做。
Therefore, they have been moved by the Holy Spirit that they have done this out of their own initiative.
等下我们就会看到了，神没有这样的交代。等下我们就会回答这个问题。
Later, we'll answer the question and also prove to you that the Lord had never required them to do this.
所以巴拿巴的真实奉献跟第五章。第一节的这一对夫妻的奉献，一比较出来就知道，一个是真的，一些是假的。
Therefore, from the offerings of Barnabas being the true offerings, in contrast, in comparison with the false offerings by Ananias and his wife, we can realize the difference.
我们中文看不出这个问题。
In the Chinese translation, it is not so apparent.
但是原文跟英文就有说 ，but 有一个人哈，然而有一个人。但是有一个人这样。
But in the original text, as well as the English translation, we have the word but to find that difference.
圣经就要让我们来知道，跟巴拿巴的奉献跟这个人的奉献做一个对比，做个检讨。
The Bible wants us to know that we are able to make a comparison between the two kinds of offerings.
所以请大家注意奉献是奉献，原来是有真奉献跟假奉献。
Therefore, let us all take note that we have two kinds of offerings, the true and the false.
所以我一直在提醒自己，一直在检讨自己啊。
Therefore, I constantly remind and examine myself.
因为教会弟兄姐妹常常称赞我们传道很爱神啊，传道把家庭放弃啊，传道把世界放弃啊，传道的奉献很大，我们到处都听到这样的赞美了。
Because we have always been given compliments and accolades that our preachers and our ministers have sacrificed the world, let go of their possessions and everything to serve the Lord God.
如果是真实的奉献，那当然感谢神，荣耀真神啊，造就教会啦。
And we thank the Lord God if those offerings are true offerings.
但是我在侍奉30年里面，我很担心，有时我们的奉献，变成有一点虚假。有一点私自留下来，留下几分，私自留下几分。
Throughout my 3 decades of my journey as a preacher, I was always worried that I would have reserved for myself a little portion of those possessions that I offered.
信不信由你呢？我常常害怕这件事情，常常提醒这件事情。
I'm not sure if you even believe me, but I've always been on my toes reminding myself on this matter.
因为在我侍奉30年里面被主耶稣责备过两次，很严厉的责备。
Because throughout my 30 years of serving the Lord God, I have been rebuked by the Lord God very strictly two times.
今天我们再一次的从圣经看两种奉献，一种是真实的，一种是虚假的。虽然在奉献，但是是虚假的。
From these few verses, we are able to see that there are two kinds of offerings, although these offerings may be true, but yet it turned out to be false.
有一些开始奉献当传道的时候就是假的。
Some of them initially when they tried to offer themselves to become preachers, it was false.
那就变成示范传道了。
是
示范，就是来示范。
They become preachers who just wanted to take up this as their career to feed themselves.
他不会考虑信徒，不会考虑教会，他是考虑他自己。
And they are not interested and not concerned about the church and the members, but only interested about their own livelihood.
那另一种呢，是真实的奉献。
The other kind of offering being the true offering.
但是啊，做久了呢，慢慢走样了，慢慢偏差了，变成有点，变成虚假了。
And after some time, they began to deviate from the right path and they became false.
这种情形我们也看得到的。
We have also seen this kind of cases.
从真的慢慢走，变成假的。
That they were true before and they ended up false gradually.
第三种奉献。
The third type of offering.
从一开始就是很纯洁的，一直到他结束，他的工作结束，还是真实的。
From beginning to the end, his work and his offering had always been true.
所以求哈，祈求哈，教会弟兄姐妹为我们祷告，求神保守我们，从一开始就是真实的，一直到结束到死，都是真实的。
And therefore, I seek your prayer for us.That we are able to serve the Lord God from beginning to the end and to offer ourselves as true offerings. Because when I look at the offering of Ananias, I myself am very concerned.
那么我们来看这个亚拿尼亚夫妻，他们两夫妻名字的意思的意义。
Let's look at the definition or the meanings of names like Ananias and Sapphira.
亚拿尼亚名字的意思是叫做神所保护的。
Ananias means the one whom the Lord protects.
第二个意思是神是恩慈的。
And second meaning being the Lord is merciful.
第三个意思是神是怜悯的。
The third being the Lord is compassionate.
什么意思呢？
What does that mean?
神是保护的，神是恩慈的，神是怜悯的。
The Lord protects, and the Lord is compassionate, and the Lord is merciful.
会不会他仗着这些哦？神是保护我的，神是有慈爱的，神是怜悯我的。会不会常常认为这样，所以敢敢去做些虚假的事情，敢敢去欺骗神？
And therefore, could it be possible that simply because he believed that the Lord God had always been this kind of nature, and he was finally bold enough?
因为反正我祷告啊，求主耶稣原谅我，我悔改一下就 OK 啦。反正神是慈爱的啦，反正神是怜悯的啦，反正神是保护我的啦，会不会这样呀？
And could it be possible that I've been thinking that Lord God has always been merciful and compassionate, and He will always protect me, and which is why it is okay for me to make a mistake or two?
老实说，我在教会侍奉三十年里面，我看到有一些信徒真的是仗着神是慈爱的，神是怜悯的。一直在做犯罪的事情。没有。
True enough, in my 3 decades as a preacher, I've always seen cases where people think that the Lord God is always compassionate and merciful, which is why they give themselves a reason and excuse to continue to sin.
他最多就是时不时来教会祷告，来教会聚聚会，又是一条好汉，又是一个热心的人啊，来做一个奉献。我看的不少呢，这种情形不少啊。
And at most, they will return to the church a couple of times to say some fervent prayers. And after that, they will end up back in their old ways.
他为什么这么大胆？
How is it that they are so bold?
因为神是保护我们的，保护我们教会的。
Because God protects us.
因为神是慈爱的，神是有充满爱的。
Because God is full of love.
因为神是怜悯的，只要我们悔改认罪，神就怜悯的。
Because God is full of mercy, as long as we repent, the Lord God will surely forgive us.
这个就是亚拿尼亚，他名字的意思就是这样。
That is the meaning of Ananias.
但是他去做这种事情。
But he has done this things.
那他的妻子叫撒菲拉，是什么意思呢？
What does Sapphira mean?
撒菲拉的意思是俊美或者是漂亮、美丽。
It means beautiful.
或者是蓝宝石，很高贵的钻石。
It also means the blue gem.
又漂亮又高贵又有价值。
Beautiful, noble, and high in value.
但是我们看到这些美丽、这些高贵，只是它的外表。它的外表真的是很美丽，真的是很有价值，因为它也跟其他信徒一样来卖产业来奉献给神，那真的是很美丽啊。
And indeed, when she offered beautifully, and she also offered all her possessions, part of her possessions, but eventually it is only superficial.
但是圣灵指责出来，把它揭开来，它里面是无味的，里面是虚假的，不是真实的。
But the Holy Spirit has disclosed her secrets that it was only false.
所以撒菲拉的名字是漂亮的，是俊美的，是蓝宝石，是有价值的，这一切全部只是在外表上而已。
Finally, we can understand that Sapphira being beautiful, being noble and valuable like a blue gem, it is only superficial.
真正能够让我们美丽的，真正能够让我们真的有高贵价值的是圣洁，圣洁。
What allows us to truly be beautiful and be high in value is our holiness.
当我们圣洁的时候，我们真的是很美丽的。
When we are holy, we are indeed beautiful.
当我们圣洁的时候，真的发出那种很荣耀的光辉，很荣耀的那种品质，那种荣美出来。
And when we are holy, we truly emit the radiance and beauty of beauty.
那个才是真正的美丽，那个才是真正的蓝宝石。
That is true beauty and true value, likened to the blue gem.
好，那我们来继续看下去。他把卖了的银钱私自留下几分。
We can continue to look back at the words. He kept back some part of the proceeds.
第二节啊。
In verse 2.
把价银私自留下几分这句话。
He kept back part of the proceeds.
私自那就是指他行事是隐秘的，不让人家知道的，叫做私自，那就是暗暗来的。
Which also means that he did this secretly.
在圣经里面有两种暗中行事，有两种暗暗行事，不让人家知道，有两种情形。
In the context of the Bible, there are two types of matters done secretly.
第一种是坏的，是做恶事，暗中做恶事，不让人家知道。
The first one being the evil deed that has been done in the dark.
就好像亚拿尼亚夫妻这样，暗中做这些恶事，不让人家知道。
Just as Ananias and Sapphira did this secretly, this evil deed secretly.
在圣经里面也告诉我们，暗中行事是做好事，暗暗的做好事。
However, there is also the context of being doing good in secret.
好像我们奉献，暗奉献，我们帮助穷人，我们暗暗的去静悄悄的去帮助穷人。
Perhaps we offer up our offerings secretly, and we offer help to, and we do charitable deeds secretly and quietly.
甚至圣经里面的说，圣经里面说，连进士都暗暗的进士，都没有人知道，都看不出你在进士，就是暗中在做这些美善的事情。
And the Bible has also recorded about fasting secretly, and people don't even realize that you are fasting. These are the beautiful things that we do in secret.
当我们看圣经暗中行事的时候，暗暗行事的时候，你要注意它有两种情况的一种是坏的。
On these two contexts, when we do things in secret, one being doing evil deeds and the other one being doing good deeds.
那么当我们夫妻之间呢如果对方有一个是错误的，是不合乎神旨意的，另一方面知道了应该要劝导他。
And among the husband and wife, when one party finds out that the other party is doing wrong, and this party should be advising him or her to do otherwise.
如果你知道对方做错了，抵挡真理了，不荣耀神的，你知道了，那么你没有规劝，没有劝他，没有阻挡他，那么你就不能够说你是清白的，因为你知道这件事情。
If you already have the knowledge that the other party has been resisting God and doing evil things, and you are not stopping him or her, then you are also an accomplice.
我有一次被神责备，就是一直想要发达了，一直想要赚钱了。
There was once when I was being rebuked by the Lord God. It was because I wanted to be rich.
那么他们呢？教会一些银行的经理哦，银行的那些高级执行人也劝传道可以去投资啦，可以赚一些钱哦，给家庭用。
And some of the administrators or even bankers of the church have also advised me to perhaps invest some money for the expenses of our family.
当传道不久，才几年而已哦。
And I was only very new, a few years into my preacher, as a preacher.
我回家就叫太太拿所有的钱哦，银行的钱、存钱、存款拿出来。
I returned home, and I asked my wife to withdraw all my savings, and put it into investment.
啊，交给那位银行的经理帮我去买股票啊，投资股票。
To hand over the savings to the bank manager that I know to invest into funds.
当然想做的时候就很多原因喽，很多理由啊，没问题的，是但是哪利息的什么啦？我们想做的时候就很多理由的啦。
When we wanted to do something, we always give ourselves a lot of reasons to justify our actions.
当然太太是讲不过我的啦。
And my wife definitely could not persuade me otherwise.
后来睡觉的时候，她只问了我一句话，她只跟我讲一句话。
And before sleep, she asked me.
她不跟我辩论。
She did not want to debate with me.
她说你做一个传道人。
She said that I, as a preacher.
你这样做有榜样吗？
If I do this, would I set a good example?
她没有问我可以不可以啊，对不对？她都不讲这些，因为这个没完没了。
She did not try to argue with me whether it was a good thing or a wrong thing to do because it will end up as an argument.
他只跟我讲一句话，你做一个传道，你这样做，你有榜样吗？
She simply asked me, if you as a preacher do this, would you set a good example?
这句话让我醒过来。
This question alone woke me up.
感谢神啊，哦，让我不会再继续的错下去。
I thank God that I did not continue to fall into my mistake.
至少我今天讲这篇道理的时候，讲到钱财道理的时候，我有力量呀，因为我走在主的道路上呀。
When I speak on this sermon of wealth and money, and I will still have power because I am walking on the path of God.
我为什么讲这个问题呢？
Why am I saying about this?
就是因为哦，亚拿尼亚的太太知道她的丈夫这样做，她应该劝她丈夫，甚至是阻挡她丈夫啊！就好像我的太太传道娘劝勉我、提醒我，甚至阻挡我。
If you look at Sapphira as the wife of Ananias, seeing Ananias' wrong deeds, she should be starting to advise him to not do this and correct him, and instead she did not.
所以被审判的时候，你不能说哇，不关我的事啊，我不知道啊，你不能够说你是清白的，因为你已经知道了。
Therefore, when judgment came upon her, and she cannot say that I did not know about this and I am innocent, no.
所以我们来看哦，教会没有规定，神也没有规定说爱主的人一定要全部财产奉献，完全没有这回事。
Now we shall look at the portion where the Lord God has never required any one of us to offer up all our possessions.
也没有立法的规定。
There is also no such law.
我们怎么知道呢？
How do we know that?
你看这个第四节，我们读第四节。
You read verse 4.
彼得责备这个亚拿尼亚说，田地还没有卖，不是你自己的吗？就是你自己的呀，你可以做主啊，要不要卖你可以决定的呀。
Here Peter rebuked her, saying that while this land has not been sold yet, isn't it still yours? You can still make decision.
这句话就很清楚了嘛，神没有勉强我们，教会没有勉强我们，田地是你的，你可以决定要卖，你也可以决定不要卖，你自由你决定。
This very question already tells us that the Lord God has never forced them or required them to sell off everything that they had, and it was still in their control.
被我们搞清楚了啊。
So we can clarify this.
那第二件事。
Second matter.
就算你卖了，既然卖了，价钱、价银不是你做主吗？就算你卖了哦，钱还是你做主啊！你要奉献多少？要奉献一半，还是要奉献三分之一，还是要奉献多少？你自己决定啊！没有规定说要全部都要奉献给神，也没有这样规定呢、啊。
And even after your land was sold, was it not still in your own control to decide how much money and a portion would you allocate to the church? Because not no one is forcing you to do this.
第一，神没有规定我们要卖田地给他，没有。
Firstly, God had never required them to sell to sell off all their lands.
第二
，Secondly,
就算你卖了，神也没有规定说你卖了的钱一定要全部奉献。不能够留下一点都不能够，也没有这样的规定，也没有这样的要求。
It's also not instructed that after you have sold your land, you will have to offer all the money that you have to the church. There's no such requirement.
我卖了一百千了，十万了，我卖了十万。
If I have sold the land for 100,000,
我觉得要奉献一点给教会，我拿出五万块来奉献给教会，可以啊。那其他的就我收下来啊，我自己收起来啊。
It is still in my control and my decision that I can offer up only 50,000 to the church and the rest would be still with me.
我跟教会讲，这个是这个我卖田地是一百千，但是我拿五十千来奉献，其他都是我自己的，可以啊。
I can surely openly inform the church that I have sold the land for 100,000 and I will offer up 50,000 to the church.
所以彼得一直在问他嘛，你卖的钱就是这些吗？问他的太太的时候嘛，
And Peter was asking the wife that was this all the money that you sold the land for？
嗯，看那个第八节嘛。
In verse 8，
你们卖田地的价钱，这钱就是这些吗？其实就在提醒他了，就是这一堆钱吗？是还是不是？其实就是在提醒他了。
Peter already reminded her to ask her this question. Tell me whether you sold the land for so much。
其实就是给他机会去反省了，给他机会去悔改了。
This was a chance given to her to repent.
有些人说彼得没有给他机会，谁说没有给他机会？
Who can say that Peter did not give her any chance?
这样问你的时候就是给你机会了嘛，你赶快承认说啊，对不起啊，我们还有留下一些，你赶快承认就 OK 了嘛，那就没事了。
When Peter gave her the second chance, and with this question again, if she said that it was not so, then she would not be, she would have no problem.
可是第八节哈，彼得问他的时候，就是这么多钱吗？卖地的，他说是啊，就是这么多呀。
And instead, when Peter asked this question, and she said yes, it is for so much.
然后就是没有悔改，还继续的来欺骗了，继续说谎了。
Which means that she was adamant, and she did not want to repent.
问题就在这里了，它整个问题的关键性是在这里了啊。
So the main problem was here.
因为有人问过我说，哇，教会圣洁的时候一定要把教会到最完全的时候一定要把田地卖吗？一定要这样吗？我说没有啊，圣经没有这样的交代，也没有看到有这样的要求啊。
Because there was someone who asked me that whether it was necessary for everyone to sell off all their possessions for the church to achieve a perfect state.
但是如果你被圣灵充满，哦，你对神有信心，而且对爱神的心很大，你自然会这样做，很自然的，不用人家讲的。
But if you have been filled by the Holy Spirit and you have faith in the Lord God, and it will be a natural thing for you to do without anyone instructing you.
我们来现在来检讨一下他们两夫妻奉献的心。哦，奉献的心有三种心，三种心。
We shall now examine on the three kinds of hearts with which the couple had offered their offer.
他们两夫妻都有一种虚假的心。
The first was the heart of hypocrisy.
他就是模仿人家许好，模仿人家去奉献，模仿。
In which they were only mimicking others in the way they offered.
模仿人家的信仰，模仿人家的奉献，模仿人家的敬拜，模仿。
They were trying to mimic the way other people worship and served and offered.
因为模仿就不是真的，是吧？模仿是不是真的？它是，它是假的，想要把假的弄成真，叫做模仿。模仿不是真的，知道吗
？Which also means that when you try to mimic someone else in doing everything, you are not doing that out of the trueness of your heart.
想要借助假的奉献来混乱，让它成为真的奉献，把它混乱。
You are trying to confuse what is false and trying to make it more confusing.
但是如果我们学习不是模仿，我们学习人家的信仰，学习人家的奉献，学习人家怎么样敬拜神，那学习就 OK 啊，学习就是正确的，学习。
On the other hand, if you learn from someone else in the ways that they worship and serve and offer, that would be no problem.
好像我们今天都一直在学习啊，传道也一直在学习啊，那没问题啊，也应该学习啊。
Because learning is what we all should do, and the preacher is always learning.
但是模仿就不一样，我在解释模仿跟学习是不一样的哦。
I'm trying to tell you the difference between mimicking and learning.
那么模仿是因为有一个虚假的心，不真实的心。
When you mimic all these things, which means you also you become a hypocrite.
第二种奉献的心呢？他们夫妻奉献是叫做贪婪的心，有一种贪婪的心，贪心呢、啊。
The second type of heart with which they offered was a heart of greed.
他贪什么？他贪教会的名利名啊，贪教会的虚浮的荣耀，虚浮的名啊。
What did they greed for? They greeded for the name and the fame in the church.
因为不是所有的人都可以奉献田地的，老实讲，没有几个可以奉献田地的。
Because not a lot of people have the ability to offer their possessions and their lands.
奉献的哦，一定在教会里面被大家称赞，被大家来羡慕了，被大家尊重，肯定的啦。
For someone to be so willing to offer up their lands and possessions for that much, they will be complimented.
所以他要想要得到在教会里面这种名望，这种被弟兄姐妹的尊重，教会里面这种好名声，他想要得到。
They want to receive this kind of respect and honor and fame in the church.
可是他又不愿意把所有的钱奉献出来，又想要得到这种称赞。
And at the same time, they are also not willing to offer up all that they had, but they wanted to be praised.
原来这个就是贪婪的心，有一种贪名在里面，贪慕虚荣啊，虚浮的荣耀呀。
This is a heart of greed for vanity.
我们在教会常常说哦，大教会都没有什么名利啦，大家都是奉献啦，大家都是爱主啦。我们常常都是这样听到那些人这样讲。
In the church, we always hear people saying that, oh, this is nothing. I'm just doing this out of love for God.
我在教会三十年了，侍奉三十年了，我不同意这样讲话。
But in the past,
因为我看到的不是这样，绝对不是真的是这样。
30 years that I served as a preacher of the church, I have not seen this truly.
教会里面也有名有利的，你知道吗？在教会里面侍奉神的都有名有利的，知道吗？你不要说没有哦。
Because serving God in a church indeed will give you honor and respect.
如果没有的，何必斗到今天？何必这么辛苦？又何必又不想下来？而且用手段去得到那个位置，去得到。
If you think that there is no honor, there is no respect given in a church for serving the Lord God, why are there people planning and schemes to try to attain all those?
没有名，没有利。你何必去打压人家？何必去把对你有威胁的？你认为对你有威胁的啊，有恩赐的啊，受人家尊敬的，受人家称赞的，你嫉妒他，你何必做这种事情
？And if there is no such honor and praise given to such work, why are there still people feeling jealous of each other?
今天教会负责人一直在斗啊，一直在争啊，到底在斗什么，在争什么呀？你说没有名没有利吗？事实上就是有了。
The ministers of the church have been fighting each other for positions and fame, and they are such honor and respect to be earned.
大家注意哦，我讲到这样实在的事情，你不要一直以为就一定是马来西亚的嘛。我讲的真耶稣教是全球性的，知道吗？真耶稣教是全球全国都全世界的真教，就是我们的教会啊，不是只有马来西亚是啊，其他的国家的真教会也是我们的教会啊，对不对？
Please take note that when I'm saying all these things, so-called the real scenarios of our church, I don't only refer to Malaysian churches, but I'm also talking about it globally.
但是我们马来西亚的负责人有没有在斗？你们自己看哦，你们自己给答案。
You can answer yourselves whether our ministers, our person in charge of our Malaysian GA, have been having such disputes. You can have a look yourself.
地方教会的负责人有没有在斗呢？圣职人有没有在斗呢？你们自己看哦。
Whether the divine workers or the ministers of the regional churches have been having this fight, you can have a look at it yourself.
然后大家说我们都是奉献的，好像亚拿尼亚也是在奉献呢、啊，他真的拿钱出来奉献呢、啊，他也在奉献呢、啊。
We argue that we are all just doing this as an offering, just as Ananias is offering.
但只是假的。
But this is false offering.
里面有贪心的，贪名利的。
It's an offering with a heart of greed.
还有他第三种奉献心叫做诡诈的心，诡诈。
The third heart with which they offered was a heart of craftiness.
为什么传道说他的心是诡诈呢？
Why am I calling their hearts crafty?
因为他留下一部分私自留下，然后又说全部，这个就是诡诈了。
Because they have kept part of the proceeds for their own interest, and this is craftiness.
那当他说全部奉献的时候，他两方面都得到，两方面他都赚到。
If they wanted to offer everything together, then they would be able to earn on both sides.
第一，他可以分享公家的财产，大家的钱财奉献给教会哦。他就可以毫无条件的享受公家的财产，他都有份。
Because the first being that if they offered everything and they are able to enjoy and share every common thing that the rest of the church would enjoy.
另一方面呢，他私上又留下一些私人的财产，他又有赚，又有留下来，所以他两方面都赚到的，知道吗？公家的他也有赚到，私下留下的也赚到，公司他都赚到。
And instead, they have also kept part of the proceeds for their own interest, for their own keeping, which also means that they want to enjoy the best of both worlds for their own and also for the church.
他们这么贪心、贪财的人、贪名、贪财的人，他们有算过的啦，他们已经算过了的，已经计划过了的，他们没有这么愚笨的啦。
People who have such greed for money and also for popularity, and they would have been so calculative, and they would not do anything that they would be at a loss for.
这就是诡诈的心嘛。
This is craftiness.
所以在圣经说，人心坏到极处，谁能识透？人心哦，非常诡诈，坏到极处，谁能看得透啊？
Therefore, the Bible tells us that who can understand the craftiness, the nature of the hearts of man being so crafty?
如果我们不深入去解释哈，去把他们的问题挖出来，很多信徒看到这一段圣经都觉得圣灵太严厉了吧，神太严厉了吧。
If we are not trying to understand the context and the background to which this happened, many people will comment that the Bible had been too harsh.
但是我们把它一件一件挖出来的时候，把他们的内心里面的诡诈挖出来，你就知道为什么圣灵要对付他们，为什么圣灵要处理他们。
We want to uncover all these evil deeds that I have done in secret, and you can understand now why has the Holy Spirit been so stern and harsh on them.
其中还有一个很重要的原因，圣灵要处理。
There's also another very important problem that the Holy Spirit had to handle.
就是我刚才讲的《使徒行传》四章三十二节。
As when I mentioned about chapter 4, verse 32.
我们再读一次32节。
Let's read again, chapter 4, verse 32.
那时许多信主的人都是一心一意，没有一个人说，请注意哦，没有一个人说他的东西有一样是自己的，没有一个人这样认为，没有一个人这样做的。
Tell us that there's not one, not even one, say that any of these they possessed was their own.
那这个是圣经的见证哦。
This is a testimony of the Bible.
也是圣灵说的话哦。
It is also the words of the Bible.
圣灵说，没有一个信徒是有私心的，全部都是这样奉献，是真实的。可是到第五章，却有两个人，这一对夫妻都是欺骗的。那么第四章三十二节的见证就变成是假的，圣灵讲的话就是不真实的，变成这样了。
Now that the Holy Spirit has testified in chapter 4, verse 32, that none of them had any personal interest or gain for themselves, but yet chapter 5 had appeared, these two crafty people.
神讲的话一定要经过考验，能够经得起考验的。他说全部是圣洁的，那一定是全部圣洁。他不能够说全部圣洁，没有一个人是污秽的。等下呢，又两三个、三四个是污秽的。那么圣灵讲的话就是没有标准。甚至是带有一点的不真实啊。
The words of the Bible and the words of God are tested and proven, and it is an absolute truth. And since there is a couple who are crafty instead of having no personal interest, and this would have proven them wrong.
所以你明白了四章三十二节圣灵做的见证，你就明白为什么圣灵不允许。这个虚假存在，这个虚假的奉献存在，你就明白了。因为圣灵讲的话，它不能够抵触，它不能够有不对的地方。
Now we can see that when we compare this chapter 4 verse 32 about the severity of this testimony by the Holy Spirit, and this is why the judgment on this couple must be so severe and harsh.
那时候我刚才介绍了嘛, 是这位最高峰、最荣耀, 达到最完全、最圣洁的那个最高峰了。 已经达到那边去了,
As I've also started the sermon with describing the church having achieved this pinnacle of glory and perfection in the state.
所以不能够容许一点的虚假污秽在里面的，不可能的。如果有污秽有虚假，那就还没有达到这个高峰了，还没有达到最圣洁的，还没有达到。
And therefore, there is no room for any falsehood, for any hypocrisy. If any of this existed, then which means the church has not achieved perfection.
这个是引起了撒旦的嫉妒啊，教会达到最荣耀的地这个程度，教会达到最爱神、最完全、最圣洁的这种程度，撒旦很不甘愿。This
was because the pinnacle of the glory of the church has caused the devil to the Satan to feel jealous and very angry.
所以他就在教会不断的看，不断的寻找，好像狮子哦，寻找吞吃的，一直在寻找，就找到这两夫妻了。这两夫妻他魔鬼看到是有虚假的，
就 利用他们来破坏了神的圣洁了。 The devil urgently prowled around like a roaring lion in the church to find anyone with any heart or any tinge of hypocrisy and falseness, and finally they identified Ananias and Sapphira. We look at 1 Corinthians chapter 5.
哥林多前书五章，我们读六节。
1 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 6.
你们这样自夸是不好的，岂不知一点面笑能使全坛发起来吗？
Your glory. A little leaven leavens the whole lump.
我们再看传道书第十章。
We turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 10.
传道书第十章，我们读第一节。
Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 1.
来，十章一节。
Chapter 10, verse 1.
使苍蝇使坐香的膏油发出臭气，这样一点愚昧也能败坏智慧和尊荣，一点的愚昧，一点的虚假。 能够使智慧、尊荣、荣耀全部被败坏掉，全部被拉下、被打垮了。
He tells us that even a little bit of folly to a respected wisdom and honor, the whole wisdom and honor would completely crumble.
所以你想，神怎么能够让一点、一两个人的污秽，让整个荣耀受到影响，让整个神教会的圣洁受到影响？当然不能够啊，不能够容许啊。
How can the Lord God allow filth and uncleanness of a couple to affect or to cause the church to crumble?
我一直在解释为什么圣灵要审判他们呢，要处理他们呢。
I'm trying my best to explain to you why the church, why the Bible or the Holy Spirit has judged the couple so severely.
因为魔鬼在教会里面放毒，在里面哦，让我们腐烂，放毒，让我们的信仰，让我们教会慢慢腐烂。
Because it's also an attempt by the devil to poison the members from within.
如果他们两个夫妻这样圣灵不处理，那以后知道的人了，也学他们，那怎么办呢？大家都虚假奉献，那怎么办？
If this pair of couple had been let loose and not been judged so severely, then the whole church would fall into, would be lumped, would be corrupted together. Then what would come of it?
那你看看现在今天真教会的情形呢？ 有很多这个也虚假，那个也虚假，传道也虚假，长老也虚假，这个什么执事也虚假，负责人也虚假，大家虚假，你不要讲我，不要讲你，大家都是一样，那么教会就不断的虚假，教会就没有办法圣洁起来，因为大家都是这样的呀，所以变成这样咯，今天的情形是这样子咯。If
we direct attention to today's context in a true Jesus church, if people are just trying to be nice and not to point out to anyone about the falsehood of any deacon or ministers, then we will continue to corrupt ourselves.
你没有发现到吗？如果有一个忠心的、一个圣洁的，他一直要求要悔改，这个人很难生存啊。这个人在这个圈子里面一定被对付，一定被责备，一定被攻击，肯定是这样。说他骄傲啦，说他不合群啦，说他自以为是啦，说他怎么样怎么样看不起同工啦，一定是这些攻击全部来。
And when you find anyone loyal or righteous or holy enough to try to resist the errors or the wrongdoings of the church, and he or she will be regarded as arrogant, as not been harmonious in the church, and will be attacked by the members.
那最痛苦说，那这个人也好，这个圣职人也好，他自己也是有软弱，他也不是神啊，他也不是天使啊，他也有做错的时候，他有说错话的时候，哇，大家就一直攻他了，所以谁还敢来讲这些道理？谁还敢来改正啊？来改过啊
？And these ministers or preachers.
自己呢？
Or any member of the church for this matter trying to advocate against the mistakes or the wrongdoings of the church, and they themselves also have weaknesses on their of their own, who will dare to speak up and try to correct the wrong?
但是如果越来越多同工能够圣洁忠心，我相信就是有机会，就会慢慢好转起来，越来越圣洁，越来越荣耀。
That as the church continues to grow and to become more holy, there'll be more and more people repenting, and we'll be on our way to a glorious state.
但是靠一两个人是不行的。But
one or two advocates are not enough.
可能这一两个人自己也会跌倒，甚至会退下了，不理了，灰心。And
this one or two of them might finally be disappointed and lose heart, and they will retreat.
这个就是魔鬼在教会里面放毒，那个毒已经很深了，已经很扩散很大了。你不要讲我，不用讲你啊，一讲大家都一样了，那个毒已经很深了。The
devil has already poisoned the church so deep enough, that no one would care to point things out anymore.
唯有神来圣灵来审判，圣灵来自行审判的权利，那就可以改过来，就可以挽回过来。
It is only until the judgment of the Holy Spirit comes that people will start to correct their ways and repent.
好像哦，圣灵马上哦，让这个亚玛尼亚死掉，然后他太太三个小时过来哦，又让他死掉，大家怕了。除非今天真教会再发生这样的事情。Just
as Ananias had died immediately on the spot, and his wife also died 3 hours later, and if this kind of judgment comes upon a true church, we will be saved.
那你就会真的是很怕，会怕神，真的很怕神，很敬畏神，也很尊重教会，你不敢再乱来了，你真的不敢再乱来啊。You
will finally fear the Lord God with a strong fear God-fearing heart, and you will not dare to do anything wrong.
所以神的审判在教会是需要的，真的需要的。Therefore,
the judgment of God is necessary, is very much needed in a true church.
传道的时间已经超过5分钟了，对不起。
I'm sorry to have exceeded my time.
那么在下一次星期六哦，星期六4点半我们再继续这一章吧。I'll
continue on this chapter the next session on Saturday.
因为今天这一堂就一直在谈这个亚拿尼亚的虚假的奉献这件事。We
have been talking about the false offering of Ananias.
哦，那就是魔鬼要让教会腐烂掉。That's
the attempt by the devil to corrupt the church.
来唱诗176首。
We sing him 176.
唱诗176首，常常有胜利。
God will always give us the victory, 176.
来，1、2、3。信徒软弱，因受害，与恶交战多失败，我依靠主，常有胜利。 魔鬼火箭如下，因忧思暗思真困苦。我依靠主，常常有胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利。胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利。得胜恩主常看顾，时刻伸手在扶助。 我依靠主，常常有胜利。虽然迷乱和怀疑如同云雾在交缠，我依靠主，常常有胜利。时时祈祷，独身经，我主旨意救人民。我依靠主，常常有胜利。 我依靠主，常常有胜利，胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利。 神恩主常看顾，时刻伸手在扶助，我依靠主，常常有胜利。最后一节，天路曲曲真难行，未到真变如用兵，我依靠主，常常有胜利。等到得胜回天父，与主耶稣同居住，我依靠主，常常有胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利，胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利。得胜恩主常看顾，时刻伸手在扶助，我依靠主，常常有胜利。祷告中，求主耶稣洁净我们的教会。
We ask Lord Jesus to purify our church.
也洁净每一个圣职人员，他侍奉神的那种圣洁的心，洁净他们的心。
And also to purify the hearts of the servants of God, the ministers of God, so that we have a God-fearing heart.
没有否认，我们的心有污秽。
We cannot deny.
的心有时也会有污秽。
That we have filth and uncleanness in our hearts, including myself.
污秽就是会骄傲。
The filth such as a tendency to be proud.
会贪心。
To be greedy.
会不会嫉妒。
To be jealous.
种种的一些不圣洁的一些事情
，all kinds of behaviors which are not holy，
要承认啊，在神面前真的要认罪。
We have to admit that before the Lord God，
这样才能够彰显出神的荣耀、圣洁、教会的美丽出来。
In an effort to demonstrate and manifest the glory and beauty of the holiness of the church，
真的要帮助我们啊！主耶稣，你真的要管教我们啊
！We need to beseech the Lord God with all earnestness that the Lord would help us。
这样我们才能够得救啊，才能够圣洁起来啊。
So that we're able to be saved and be holy.
我们一直祷告，我们生病了，有癌症了，有发烧了，有在医院了，我们一直为这些祷告，没有错了。我们为这些祷告没有错了。
All the things that we have been concerned about in our prayer had always been someone is ill and someone is contracted with a.
所有的病都是肉体的，会腐烂的，会坏掉的，都是肉体的病来的。
But we have to realize that our bodies will eventually corrupt and deteriorate.
有多少人真正的为我们的灵魂、我们的圣洁、我们的生命来祷告？我们的灵魂生病了，我们的灵魂中毒了，我们的灵魂有癌症了。有多少人为这个来祷告，认真的看待这个事
？But how many of us have realized enough to start to pray for our spiritual selves and our spiritual health, because we have been poisoned spiritually and contracting cancers spiritually?
一起祷告吧。
Let's pray together.